Betsy, it is awesome to have you on the Empowered Author Podcast. Thanks so much for joining.
I am excited to be here. I'm like thrilled to talk about podcasts on your podcast.
Right? Like, I can't think of a better way to kick off the Empowered Author Podcast than to have a whole season focused on podcasts, right? A podcast about podcasts for nonfiction authors. I'm really pumped to have that. You know, I'm a really also a firm believer that absolutely nothing in life happens by chance. I think it all happens for purpose, on purpose, with purpose. And I think our connection and how we met is total proof of that. You know, I will never forget, I was sitting down watching, you know, Netflix one evening when I get a LinkedIn pop asking if we could connect, you and I. And that was the beginning of something much bigger.
Yeah, it was funny because I also am not a big LinkedIn person. And I was like, oh, Stephanie, she looks like someone who, like, we might have some good, like, energy here and some good ways to collaborate. I wonder if she would be willing to connect. And you did and immediately messaged me. And we had, like, I had this capsule podcast sort of idea on how it might work. And you had all of the gaps filled on how it would work perfectly for your authors. And we just can't stop talking about it since.
I know. I mean, ever since we connected, I feel like every day we're like, what about this? Did you think about this? And I think that's a beautiful experience or an example for people that you should always step outside of your comfort zone and do something that some days you might not consider doing, because that typically, especially to author, to the listeners listening in today, typically it can turn out to be something even bigger, even better, even more exciting and empowering than you had ever dreamed. And that's what I think we're doing. That's what I think that the Capsule Podcast concept has the power to absolutely do. The crazy thing too, Betsy, is once we connected, we realized that our lives have actually been connected before. What are the odds? So that's crazy.
Yeah, it was crazy. We both worked for the same nonprofit, sort of in different eras, overlapping a little bit. But that was a while ago for me. That was over a decade ago. It felt like just similar paths leading to this same place and the same energy and the same want to help people and serve people. And it all just kind of like aligned. And I'm so excited to be working
with
you. Me too.
It's also proof, in my opinion, that every experience in life layers to where you're supposed to be. If I hadn't worked at that specific nonprofit for a decade, then I would not have the experience today to be able to collaborate with you to create a beautiful opportunity for other people and to inspire and empower individuals to think about podcasting a bit different than how they probably ever would have thought about that. And I think that is how the Capsule Podcast concept has come to be, correct? So tell us a little bit, you know, you're a podcaster. So tell us about that journey.
I will. I am a podcaster. So My podcasting journey began, I guess, a couple of years ago, three-ish years ago, with my sister. We co-host a podcast together about cooking dinner. And we've done that every week. Yeah, it's fun. It's super fun. We try new recipes and then talk about it. So we've done this every week for 3 years. And we have, like, you know, 12, 13,000 people a month listening, which awesome. Is amazing. And they're making all these dishes and it's super fun. And as I've been in the podcasting space and looking around to see what other people are doing, what's going on, I mean, I just fell really, really deeply in love with podcasting as a medium, as a format for getting your message out. And one thing I noticed was that we were all making these same weekly shows, kind of like every week consistent. This was the one message that people were talking about or the one way to do it. But if you looked at brands and if you looked at corporate and different things, a lot of corporate company kind of podcasts were these mini series that they were launching for product launches. Mm. So like Reebok put a new shoe out and they did a 3-episode launch podcast. Or you had Prudential Insurance and they were launching a new product and they put a 6-episode podcast cool. out for that. And as I was sort of like taking in all of this, I thought, why don't more people should use this like standalone miniseries, this launch podcast or this promotional podcast format, instead of always going to the weekly show. Because as a person who hosts a weekly show, it is a lot of work. It just is. And you hear that all of the time. And the solutions we hear are make it less work for yourself. So like hire a producer, hire this out, figure out how to make that big commitment less work. And my whole kind of idea with Capsule Podcast was how do we use this model that we see clearly successful in corporate and used with brands so that we flip it on its head. We're saying, let's throw all of that out. Let's not just try to make this less work. Let's do it differently. And so we don't create that whole ongoing kind of situation for us. So a capsule podcast is a 6-episode standalone miniseries. Each episode is 15-ish, 20 minutes long, and it integrates with your marketing strategy. So this is something that you and I connected on immediately. Yep. Because I said, our conversation was mostly about the fact that people make podcasts that aren't connected with all of the other assets and parts of their marketing strategy. So you don't want to be producing a podcast over here and the rest of your marketing plans over here. You want to make these 6 episodes so that they are used just with precision, super strategically across all of your marketing.
You have hit the nail on the head. And that is something I have realized specifically in the author industry is it's really easy to get excited about the shiny new thing. Believe me, I have a problem with that myself. I'm a chronic shiny new thing follower. I love it. I get very excited about it. And it's okay to do that when it makes sense with your overall marketing strategy. And the unfortunate reality is most things don't. So many times you will go down a path where you're very excited about something and you've done it and you've seen other people do it. You've seen other people do it with success. And yet you can't understand, well, you just did it. Why did it not achieve the same level of success that someone else did? And a lot of that comes down to the fact that you saw it through the wrong lens. Now, before we go into too much more depth on strategy versus tactics, something you said triggered something to me. And it was around this investment concept in podcasting. And I think I want to talk on this a little bit more. And I think about this quite frankly, in anything you touch, there is some sort of an investment, whether or not that's financial or not. So when you're looking at podcasting and like you have with your cooking show, which I think is amazing because you're building a relationship, deepening your relationship with your sister, in addition to filling your belly and inspiring other people, what a win, win, win on so many fronts. But what you needed to keep in mind and what I think authors need to keep in mind is really two key investment components. One is a time investment and two is your financial investment. And many authors will say, oh my gosh, I have a great message. I'm going to do a weekly podcast. Great. Maybe that's the right solution for you, but you do need to consider the time that it takes to execute and plan and strategize for it. Because remember, it's a tactic to a strategy, not the strategy. But then you also need to think about, do you have the funds to invest financially to make it a credible podcast? I mean, you know, Betsy, you probably know many and have seen many podcasts that have been done very organically, that are done beautifully, and many who have been done organically that have failed miserably. And as a marketer, it pains me to see people try something, but not give it both the time and financial investment that it really deserves. Would you agree? Have you seen stuff like that?
Yeah, I have. And I mean, I think most people, if you've listened to a podcast and you are on your radio dial in the car and you're turning it up and turning it down because you can't get the volume right and it's all over the place and it turns you off. First of all, it leaves a bad taste in your mouth. And then the other thing too is if you're investing your time and your money into a piece of your marketing strategy, you just need to be really smart about it. If you do it in a way that isn't aligned with everything else, it's just a waste of time and money and resources. And none of us are wanting to do that, right? Like no one wants to just make something that sort of sits there and collects digital dust, as they say, right? Like, that's not the goal. So but at the same point, I think I really do want people to be able to experiment with a podcast format because it's fresh, it's new, it's kind of the future of marketing. A lot is branded podcasting. So let's experiment with it in a way that reduces the overall risk to you in terms of
time and money investment. I love that. I love that. And I think being smart and wise in how you consider your financial and time investment is the way to go, especially on the side of being an author and an entrepreneur. So let's talk a little bit more about strategy versus tactic. I think that that gets very confusing for people at times, because what will happen is they will dive into something and they feel like that's their strategy, but really their strategy is something completely different, or should be something completely different. That's actually a specific tactic. And I think many podcasters, authors turned podcasters, typically look at the podcast as a strategy for something instead of a tactic. And because they're looking at it as a strategy, they're approaching it through a different lens. That's why they're thinking, I've got to do one a week or two a week. And they create this unrealistic approach that, quite frankly, can burn them out and might not ever see a return on investment in their time and their financial components there. So what I really fell in love with on the Capsule Podcast concept, and I'm going to say Capsule Podcast as a concept with kind of air quotes, because not only is that the name of your business, but to me, that is the name of a product, a unique way to look at podcasting is through this Capsule Podcast lens. So let's talk a little bit about that and about, you know, why do you feel like six episodes makes a really beautiful kind of capsulated experience? What is it about that?
So six podcasts is going to give you enough time to get a little depth, have people get to know you, but in a way that is consumable for our audience too. We want to think about people's lives and how they're consuming content, right? And if they are thinking about a new book they might want to read, or in our case, like cookbook authors, or hear from someone in that space, I would love to hear six episodes from that person that are kind of short that I can listen to in between other things, some behind the scenes, some like about you as an author and your journey, some kind of insider information to kind of really deepen that connection. I don't necessarily need to hear from you every single week for the rest of my life, right? Like, I am really interested in this book that I heard about and about you right now. So let's talk about this book and let's talk about you right now. And I would love that information as I am deciding whether or not I want to buy that book, or as I'm deciding whether or not I want to come see you at an event or do something like that. Give me those six episodes so that I can listen to exactly what you want me to hear versus me going into a back catalog of 300 episodes and then you're putting something new out every week and I'm just like, I don't even know where to start with this. You can give me exactly what you think that I should hear that's aligned with your marketing strategy that will make you, make me as a reader want to come with you on that, you know, on this book journey or on the, you know, to this live event.
I love not only that perspective and strategic approach, but I love how a capsule podcast also can be most cost effective. So if making a financial investment is something that you get a tad nervous about, it's okay, because in the way that a capsule podcast is done, it's not a long-term investment. It's a very focused investment. So before we go any further, I just want to make it really clear, and I feel like I need to pause and be honest, because about podcasts in general, do I think every author should have a podcast? I don't know. Probably not. Not without a strategy, at least. So, you know, my opinion or my thoughts are, if you're considering a podcast, even a capsule podcast, I'm going to challenge you to pause and ask yourself, why do you want to do this? Why? What would be the point? Why have a podcast at all? And how does that align with your business, your overarching strategies? How are you going to make the time investment to make your podcast worth it? I'll be honest, I have wanted to do a podcast for years. It's been a part of my bucket list for quite some time. And it wasn't until you and I met that I had the aha moment and I decided, oh my goodness, this capsule podcast concept is perfect for my business as well, my authorpreneur business. And it's really been a great and a time investment, financial investment solution to help me ensure that my podcast meets my needs, my wants, as well as those of the people that I'm trying to reach. Oh my gosh, Betsy, we have talked about some really cool stuff and we have a lot of stuff left in queue for the rest of the season. I am really, really pumped to dive into all things Capsule Podcast, from internal launch, external launch, authorpreneur tools, opt-ins and lead magnets. We might even uncover words that people don't even know they need in their vocabulary, and how a Capsule Podcast can actually help make that happen. So no matter why you want to choose to launch a podcast, even though I just said I don't think everybody should have one, if it's something you've considered, or if something in this podcast series, I don't know, makes you pause and think, now might be a really good time, and here's why. So Buzzsprout, which is a platform that helps people turn their podcasts into reality, have some really interesting statistics that I found, Betsy, and I know you are a big fan of using Buzzsprout, but these statistics were really interesting. Buzzsprout shared some statistics. It was, podcasts are the number one way to genuinely connect with your audience, because here's why. They hear you, they feel your emotion, they can become loyal, they listen, they want to know more. But this is the other statistic I think is quite staggering. It's that the podcast industry has a lot of quote unquote unexplored space. Buzzsprout noted specifically in a recent article that there are at least 600 million blogs, 23 million YouTube channels, but only 800,000 podcasts and Apple Podcasts. So what that means is for every podcast, there are 750 blogs and 29 YouTube channels. So like, let that sink in. Your reach through a podcast has much potential. All right, Betsy, we have a lot coming up. Thank you so much for joining us on this episode. We have 5 more to go, so much more to cover. And I can't wait for us to dive in and talk specifics about the various tactical ways that a Capsule Podcast can really play a meaningful part in any author's marketing strategy.